Hello, this is Dr. Arberg, and this presentation will discuss coding of offline programming. We recall that in previous presentations, we opened up a new project with this icon. We then imported a 3D module, and we brought in the process scene into the RoboCell programming environment. We had in the process a robot, a box, conveyor, and a sensor. We also taught the robot its process positions. There were seven positions. We used a few commands such as open and close gripper. We today use new commands like start conveyor and close conveyor. We also have a command which is called remark. Remark is shown over here, allows us to put non-executable commands that allow us to nicely organize the program with lines and comments. We will use a label command. A label simply defines a group of commands that are done together in order to complete a definite process. Sometimes it's called subroutine. For example, over here, all these commands are under the label of monitor sensor. We see the monitor sensor label right in here. Another command that we'll use today is the checking up if an input is on. So we specify the input number. In our case, it's input number one. And if it is on, then we send the robot to a certain routine, such as we saw on a flowchart. The flowchart starts with a process that picks up the part from position 1-1 and places it on the conveyor belt at the position 1-2. Then the robot goes to position 2-2 for park. We set up a variable count equal to 1, and then we start the conveyor. We monitor the sensor to find if the part reaches the sensor. And then if the part reaches the sensor, we stop the conveyor. If the part did not reach the sensor, we continue the process until the sensor sends a signal to input one, which is on. This process takes repeats every 1 millisecond. So there are 1,000 times a second that sensor is being monitored in this loop. When we stop the conveyor, we increase the counter by 1, and then we check if the number of counts is less than 3. Then we continue the process in a loop. We start the conveyor again after we bring the part to the start position in this block. And then if the count is greater than 3, we stop the process with this block by taking the part and bringing it back to its start position. The process of writing the software is, as we see here, divided into three sections. We have one section, which is the start, another section, which is the stop, and then the third section is the loop and monitoring. We have here the first section, which is the start. We have here the last section, which is the finish. And over here, we monitor. So it's important to have a clear definition of the flowchart, because then it helps us to be consistent in writing the program for the code. Let's see the analogy. We have start and start. and then picking up the part from this position to this position has several commands. We first go to position 2-1, which is approach position for point one, and we do this at high speed 99, doing it a joint motion. Then we open the gripper, get ready for pickup. Then we go down with linear motion at a relatively slow speed. We reach that point, which is 1-1, and we close the gripper. Then we back up to the approach position, position 2-1. We go then to position 2-2, right above the conveyor at high speed. And then we come down to position 1-2, right on the conveyor. At slow speed, we open the gripper, and then we go to a park position with the robot at a slow speed. Now, the park position in this case will be 0.22, right above the conveyor. We then close the gripper. The reason why we close the gripper is because if we have next motion to another approach position, then we like the gripper to be closed such that we reduce the chance of hitting parts as we move. And this completes this section. Then we set variable count to one, the same way as it says over here. And we start the conveyor. We start the conveyor on the flow chart. We start the conveyor here. When we start the conveyor, we could set up the axis, axis seven. And then we can also dictate the speed, whether it's in minus direction or plus direction. Then comes the monitoring section. Over here, we check if input one is true. And the same thing is we're doing over here. If input one is on, then we jump to loop, meaning that the part arrives at this destination. If not, we jump back to monitor and we go through this loop. You see, when we run the program, there's quite a bit of repetitive move, which will be highlighted in red. Until the sensor detects the part. Once we are on the outside of the loop, we come over here to stop the conveyor, the same way as over here, and then we set the counter to add one digit, count equal count plus one, and the next thing is we check the number of cards. So if counts is greater than three, we jump to finish over here. If the count is less than three, then we execute this command. Now let's see what this command is. This command says that go to position 2-3, and then this is the approach position to point three, and then open the gripper, then go down to position 1-3 at a slow speed, close the gripper, catch the part, go to linear position back to 2-3, and then go to position 2-2 right above the conveyor, and then go to position 1-2, slow speed, open the gripper, lift the part on a conveyor, and then go to position 2-2 to park and open the close the gripper. Then after we finish this process, we go to start conveyor. And you see over here that we go to start conveyor. If the number of parts is greater than three, then we go to finish. As we see over here, the finish command has over here, let's get this down. The finish command has it starts by going to position 2-3, and then opening the gripper, coming down to position 1-3, closing the gripper, go back to 2-3. From 2-3, we go to position 2-1, right above the position 1, and then we come down linearly to position 1-1. We open the gripper to leave the part on the desk. Then we come back to position 2-1, the approach position. From that, we close the gripper when we move long travel at high speed. And then we go to position 99, and that will end the program. what we like the students to do in this exercise is to repeat the process, review the block diagram in detail, and then create step by step the process of load and unload the conveyor belt. Thank you.